Conventional wisdom these days says that robots will soon put millions of factory workers out of jobs. This may sound like the fever dream of Dr. Evil, but in fact, there are very pleasant people making this happen. May I introduce Suzanne Gilbert, a budding AI overlord and founder of Toronto startup Kindred AI.
Tell me about these guys.
So these are research prototypes. So they're some of the first robots we built at Kindred. So we tend to work with small robots. It's a bit like if you imagine a child growing up and it breaks a lot of things. Now imagine if the child was 6 feet tall when it had the brain of a 6-month-old. It would be terrible, terribly dangerous.
How many of these robots have ever slapped you?
I have been hit in the face by robots a couple of times.
And is that like, Suzanne seems nice enough. She makes exotic digital art. And she loves cats to the point where she's built a robotic fleet of them for the office.
This one, I believe, is called Pinkfoot. It's a quadruped robot loosely based on a cat anatomy, although it's not a very highly faithful representation yet.
And then when you were growing up, you would build things as well?
Yeah, that's correct, yeah. So I was really enthralled by electronics at an early age. I guess most little girls would be looking at trays of beads and things, and I was looking at trays of like resistors and capacitors and little components, but having the same kind of reaction to them.
But don't be fooled by the hobby electronics and the cute cat bots. Suzanne is a keen businesswoman. And Kindred has recently embarked on its first commercial venture.
What's going on here is we have a bank of robots that are learning. So they are continuously running, picking up objects.
These would run all day?
All day, all night.
Powered by state-of-the-art AI, these arms can do something that's very easy for a human, but very hard for a bot. Pick up objects of different shapes and put them down. Most factories still use people to do that sort of thing. Lots and lots of people.
Today, everyone's shopping on e-commerce. Thousands and thousands of different types of objects, shapes, textures, weights. How do you pick that up? Right now, it's humans. You have millions of humans in warehouses just like picking up things and putting it into another location. So we're teaching our robots how to do that.
What's the hard part? It's figuring out what's a belt, what's a shirt, or it's just how to grasp it.
Yeah, exactly. It's figuring out how to pick it up, right? So things will show up in any shape, right? And you got to figure out how to pick it up without dropping it, put it in the location. So it takes a lot of training.
Part of that training involves, of all things, humans, robot pilots who manually control the arms, while the AI watches and learns the finer points of grabbing.
All right, ma'am, teach me how to use this thing.
All right, have a seat. So you see a 3D mouse here. This lets you navigate the arm through three-dimensional space. So imagine you're holding the arm in that left hand and you're just moving it around. Move it slowly and gently. There you go.
Trying to get the Oreos. I gotta go up. Oh, shoot. I went too far up. I want these Oreos.
Oh!
You killed the
baby. You lose.
Come back to the arm. There. Success. It's like being at an arcade.
Basically.
It's like you actually get to win something.
Exactly.
Just down the hall, Kindred keeps a room full of pilots doing the same thing as me. Only these guys are actually competent. They're remotely overseeing some arms in a Gap factory, 1,000 miles away in Tennessee.
How long have you been a robot pilot?
Just over a month, actually. I've only been here 5 weeks.
What was the training process like?
Almost like playing a video game.
It's like a shirt gone.
That's a backpack.
That's a backpack, okay. Somebody's undies. Oh, there it goes.
Yeah. One shirt at a time.
As the arms observe their human guides, they gradually learn how to do better at picking up t-shirts and shoeboxes. Eventually, they'll be fully autonomous, and size services will no longer be required.
One day, this is just gonna light up, and it's gonna be picking the objects on
its
own.
Pretty much, that's the ultimate end goal for, at least for these, to have it just constantly whirring and going.
And the people will be free.
The people will be free to do other more important things.
Sai seemed kind of happy about the prospect of unemployment. But I was concerned for his future.
Isn't there something grim about the human training there? And
it's not good to take people's jobs away, but this kind of technology coming into the workforce should make us start thinking about how we're going to pay people in the future, because AI is not just going to automate, you know, manual labor jobs. It's going to automate things like doctors and lawyers and accountants very soon. So I think there's going to be issues. There's going to be a lot of disruption when these things come online.
Suzanne is a realist, but she's also an optimist. In her vision of the future, robots won't be mindless competitors to humanity. They'll be full-fledged citizens like the rest of us.
One of the crazy ideas I've seen you talk about was you've got a robot and it's working in a factory and then it's got to go, maybe it gets paid a wage and it goes to buy lithium ion batteries to keep it going. Why would that have to happen?
I mean, if you're having a physical body, they will have a lot of physical needs, just like we have. You might have to go to the repair shop to get like a motor looked at or something like that, and they'll have to pay someone to do that. I think they'll just be contributing to our economy in the same way we do. And if they have brains like us, they'll want to explore new things they've never seen before. They'll want to learn things. They'll want to perhaps rest so that their mind has time to consolidate all this new information.
I keep trying to picture it in my head, though. So does the robot worker, does he go home and sit on the couch and watch TV after work? And he's...
I don't see why not. I'd probably watch cat videos like the rest of us.
I mean, when you...
It's hard to tell sometimes if Suzanne is laughing with us or at us. Either way, I plan to clear a nice spot on the couch for my robot friends, oil up some delicious popcorn, and smile politely.
Thanks for watching, and if you want to see more Hello World, click on the link to subscribe.